Morning, right here on ENCA channel 403. We come to this now. We know South Africans love to travel, but unfortunately, the detection of the 501 Y.V2 COVID-19 variant resulted in travel restrictions to and from the country. Now, the tourism department has published a report detailing how the sector plans to revive itself, as well as when international travel is likely to resume. To talk everything tourism, we're now joined by Minister Mmamoloko Kubayi-Ngubane. Thank you so much, Minister, for your time, and good morning to you. Minister, I mean, we know that our borders are open and at least that allows for some activity to proceed and to continue. However, when it comes to international travel, you're facing a couple of challenges there where a growing number of countries have imposed some restrictions for travel from South Africa to their countries. How does this road to recovery plan aim to resolve this?
Good morning and good morning to your viewers. Yeah, indeed, we've literally started working on international market that is currently one of the areas that we're not seeing the numbers that we want to see. As you have indicated, the variant and miscommunication, I must say, led to where we are, where many countries, because of fear and not understanding how we're managing the pandemic, led to closing South Africans out in terms of if you come from South Africa, you go into that country. So our outbound market has been affected because when you arrive in those countries, you need to quarantine. Or even in terms of their country citizens, when they come to South Africa, there are restrictions. So that has become a huge, stumbling block, if I may put it in that way, in terms of us reaching the numbers. How we've started working, because we started working on the tourism sector recovery strategy, and it's currently in cabinet. We're hoping by next week it will be approved that we can be able to take South Africans fully in detail in what we plan to do. But one of the things that we want to work around is partnership with private sector so that we can be aggressive in our engagement in the global market,
right,
and as well our aggressive marketing in those areas. While from government point of view, through diplomatic channels, engaging those governments so that we can explain what we are doing with the virus, because we still don't believe, we don't understand why this imposing of the restrictions to South Africa, because when you compare us with many countries, our numbers are very low, fatality is very low, recovery is high,
yeah.
So that does not make sense in terms of how they are reacting to South Africa. And that's why we believe it's a miscommunication.
Right. And Minister, speaking of the miscommunication that you referred to, I suppose even some people can describe it as a stigma. It seems, you know, there's a growing stigma that South Africa is a country not to travel to, and for those coming from South Africa not to travel to other countries because of this new variant. I mean, you speak about how you plan to have conversations with your international counterparts, but also there are growing fears of a third wave. I mean, what's the messaging that you plan to take internationally?
We have started, actually not that we're going to start, we have started, we're currently engaging in one of several of our key source markets. German, even this evening, I would be interviewing with some of the German TV stations, because what we picked up is that we need to send the right message, but we need to send the correct message. So when this variant happened and was found, and the UK minister went out and did those interviews, they were widely widely captured and viewed. And when we came back, I think we took long as South Africa to come in and clarify what had happened. And obviously, it could have been the issue that we also were still trying to understand this variant and also understand its implication. So once we had done that, to go back and start changing, viewers need to understand in diplomatic environment, for example, if a country imposes a ban,
right,
they either put it for 3 months or 6 months. It's not removed automatically. It waits to be lapsing.
Mm.
So the work that we are doing currently is to say we need to engage in this country so that when it lapses in the 3 months, meaning from April, many of them would start lapsing in May and June. They do not put other restrictions.
Right.
So that when we come to our summertime, we have the numbers that we're looking for. We do note from tourism point of view that winter is not a peak season for us, and also because it's going to likely to be, it's a flu season. Whether it becomes a third wave or not, But where we are sitting is that, would you utilize this period between now and end of July
right.
as part of engaging, as part of bringing in those platforms to start opening and making sure that the bookings for later this year happens?
I need to jump in there, Minister, if I may. You speak about bookings and you know your hope and your plan to ensure that they do happen. But I'm sure you would understand that the recent suspension of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, surely that adds to your woes. Business at this point being uncertain. Those hoping that the vaccine would have assisted just in reassuring, holiday makers and tourists that there is safety and precaution being taken here. How are you dealing with this, especially with some of your stakeholders, including businesses, with regards to this uncertainty?
Look, definitely, as we have been saying, you know, we take it one step at a time as tourism. It does sometimes cause frustration and concern, even from our side, because you feel like you're chasing a moving target. Now, with what has happened, obviously, Minister Mkhize took us into confidence in terms of our NCCC to say, this is coming up, this is what it is. And because the IMC now is looking at it to be able to see, because one, the advisory panel has advised, obviously, to say, we need to put on hold. We are concerned from the tourism point of view because vaccine rollout becomes one of the enablers for tourism to thrive again. Vaccine rollout assures our travelers to come in. When we went to cabinet as well, was to be able to say the vaccine rollout remains a very critical path for tourism recovery and economic recovery. So the work that is being done to re-bring us back, I know that it's not yet at that time, and the MEC would want to give them space together with the IMC to look at it and come back to all of us who are not part of that process
right.
to be able to give us confidence that we would be able to have this back on track and we can rebuild confidence. Our travelers, even now, they do ask us as tourism to say, when I come to South Africa being vaccinated, would I interact with a person who's not vaccinated? Mm. Will that put me in risk? So those questions are already there. We are picking them up in terms of our international market. And this is the feedback we've given to our colleagues in cabinet to say, this is what we need you to help us with.
Right. Minister, we're running out of time, but I have to ask you this last question, if I may, Minister, due to time. I mean, I'm sure you've seen the reports of Solidarity accusing the tourism department of almost, choosing a specific agenda or prioritizing a specific agenda as opposed to prioritizing all citizens. Now, this is with regards to the 1.2 billion rand tourism fund. First question is, what are your thoughts on these remarks? And second, how many businesses or other people have benefited from the fund so far?
Yeah, I think it's unfortunate. It's 1 year. Again, we were in court at this time with AfriForum and Solidarity last year on the tourism relief fund. We won the case. This year again, tomorrow, we'll be in court with AfriForum and Solidarity. And I do believe that we have a strong case. Tourism is a sector that is not transformed. So because of COVID, you don't put off hold what becomes your policy directives. So policy dictates that Minister of Tourism needs to ensure that if you build a sector, you must build an inclusive sector. Now, this is not segregating others. I can tell you now, we opened the application, and this is supposed to be the 1.2 is meant for 3 years. We opened the application in January. And we're hoping that at least some smaller groups will come in this year and another one this year.
Right.
I can safely say to you, we received application worth 3.2 billion. We only have 1.2. Now, it tells you the need out there. It tells you the appetite, because this is about entrepreneurs who are saying, we do have what we want to do in the
right.
tourism sector, but we are battling because we do not have the support. Financial sectors have not been able to come on board in supporting tourism. And this is reflected in the 2015 Tourism Transformation Report, in the 2018 Transformation Report. So what the Minister of Tourism is doing is not out of her head or out of her madness, but it's out of reports that have said, you need to do something as government and you need to intervene. And this is the intervention.
Minister,
in terms of responding to the need of transformation in the tourism sector.
We appreciate your time. Minister Mmamoloko Kubayi-Ngubane, Minister of Tourism, thank you so much for joining us.